It can take weeks to make a passport. It can take a few hours, depending on the quality of passport that the forger is actually making.
Tony Sale spent 15 years forging passports in the UK before he was sent to prison in 2009.
By just gently picking the edge of a passport, and now you can start to peel the passport back.
Here he is changing the name on this passport to mine.
Anything can be faked. Someone actually made this passport. That means it can be repeated again. You can see how close through to the picture we actually are here.
According to Interpol, approximately 40 million passports have been reported stolen since 2002. Some of them sold illegally to people who look similar enough to the original bearer.
Even if you look a little bit like that person, that's going to be good enough.
Others end up in the hands of counterfeiters.
There's a huge black market for stolen passports. It's absolutely huge. It's, you know, probably on a daily basis, an average fraudster buys 5 or 6.
But forensic document examiner Gideon Epstein says a counterfeit passport is more likely to raise red flags at airport security than a stolen one, because many countries have implemented passport security features to prevent alteration. For example, the first page of the US passport contains an image of an eagle with 13 arrows, while a fake passport might have just 11 or 12. And watch as the letters USA change color under ultraviolet light.
We are working to introduce a next generation passport that will even have additional forensic features. But no matter how good you are, someone's always going to be trying to beat the system.
Especially when it comes to theft. Not every country regularly checks Interpol's database to see if a passport is stolen. Two men on Malaysia Airlines Flight 370 were allowed to board with passports that had been reported stolen in 2012 and 2013. One solution, passports like these that contain a microchip with biographical data designed to prevent them from being used by the wrong person.
Border security officials all over the world can read that data and validate that you are who you say you are.
But many countries, particularly in the developing world, are still behind on implementing them.
We've seen a lot of the new electronic passports come in that have made definitely forging a passport much more difficult. But of course, every system has its weaknesses.
And Tony says that back in the day, for a top quality fake passport, he would charge roughly between $8,000 and $10,000. Now he's since mended his ways. He got out of prison in 2010. He now works to educate companies on retail and passport fraud. Now, if you find a passport that is lost, or you know of a passport that has been stolen, it is very important that you report it to the authorities, because naturally the last thing we want is for it to end up in the wrong hands. Zain Asher, CNN, New York.